All right, girls, welcome to tonight's team call. I am Corey Mayo, and I am super excited to talk to you girls a little bit about five things that you can do right now in this time of craziness to help you keep focused and keep some routine in your everyday schedule. Because I know that right now that the kids are home, you might be home from work as well, that your husband might be home. Like, routine is just totally out the window for us right now during this quarantine. And I know that that can be a little bit scary. It can be kind of exciting because you might be working on some things around the house that you haven't been able to get done. But it's so important for us to create routine and for us to keep some sort of a schedule, especially if you have kiddos and you're having to homeschool right now. Okay. So keeping that routine is going to be essential for you keeping on path with your own goals. Not just with your business goals, but also with your nutrition and your fitness goals, because it's going to help you keep that everyday schedule as far as your eating and your meals too. Okay. So I want you to try to find the silver lining in this situation, to try and embrace this opportunity that we have. Okay. I understand that it is challenging for all of us. We want to try and stay away from social media because we want to stay away from a lot of the negativity. But you guys, as coaches, we need to be that positive light and be on social media more as far as posting and loving on those around us. You can tune out the news feed and still send 3 to 5 messages every day to light someone else up, okay? To send 3 to 5 invites in their inbox and to post your personal journey and how you're working through this situation right now without even going into your newsfeed, okay? So I want you to keep that in the back of your mind. This is an opportunity to really step up, to create that discipline within our daily routine, because we are home right now. We don't have a lack of time. We have more than enough time right now in this situation to take and embrace the opportunity to grow our business, to be a positive influence for those around us, to share healthy tips and activities and how you're keeping yourself busy and working through this situation and giving pointers to those around you. Because oftentimes people who are following us are several steps behind where we are right now. So the tools that you're using every day, whether you get up and you read a devotional every day, or you have a gratitude journal that you write in every day, or you're reading your personal development book, which you should be doing all of those things as a coach, but all of those things are steps to help empower more health and happiness and to relieve the anxiety and stress that people are feeling right now. So just want to remind you of that, okay? Take this as an opportunity to really be that positive influence to those around you. So tip number one for keeping yourself in a disciplined routine into some sort of normalcy during this time of life, and that we are home and we are kind of limited on being able to go outside of the home, is to get up and start your day like normal, okay? If you normally got up at 5:30 in the morning, don't change that just because you have time throughout the day because you're home now. Use that time to hustle and work your business and show up for yourself before you have to get into the activities that need to be done at home, whether it's homeschooling or the projects you want to do around the house or just normal everyday chores that we all hear in the back of our minds. Oh, the laundry needs to be done. The dishes need to be taken out of the dishwasher. The kids' rooms need to be organized. This needs to be clean. That room needs to be swept. Like, there's so many different things pulling us in so many different directions, but we have to stop that noise before it even starts. Okay. So get up, get yourself into the habit of being in a routine. If you want to sleep in on the weekends a little bit, fine. But you guys, the other thing to think about too is during this high stress and high anxiety time, depression is going to be a high factor. Like, that's going to be something that a lot of people are struggling with, those different stressors and depression. So that is only worse or I can't think of the word that I'm thinking of. It just gets worse the more that we sleep, the more that we sit around, the more that we do nothing, because we kind of feel sorry for ourselves and we can't get ourselves out of that slump. So get yourself up. get moving, get yourself into that morning routine. Are you doing your devotional and your gratitude and then working out? What does that look like for you? In the wellness studio, we have our 6 a.m. to 6:30 a.m. And I know for some of you, that's too early because you're on a different time zone, but that 6 to 6:30 virtual gym is going to be so helpful in getting you to get into that routine and showing up for yourself. So making sure you're getting up and you're getting your day started right is number one. Tip number two is having a list of daily to-dos. So this little tracker is what we should be using every single day. But like, what are the other things that you have to get done in life? Like, does the laundry need to be done? Do you need to do homeschooling? We need to really, especially in this time of being home, schedule out those days of blocking out our times, okay? So I personally have gone through my Google Calendar and I have blocks of time where I have from 5 a.m. until 5:30, I think, is just like me getting up and doing my devotional and get moving around. And then from 5:45 until 6:30, it's the virtual gym. From 6:30 to 7:30, it's me working and doing my stories and connections and all of that. And then from 7:30 until 9, it was, and it still is, shower, get the kids up, get them moving, get ready for the day. And then from 9 until 3, I'm at the farm. So I don't do a whole lot of work during those hours. And then from 3 until 4:30, that is like my wrap up. What did I not get done? Maybe it's follow-ups. Maybe it's more invites. Maybe it's doing another 15-minute power packet, whatever that looks like. And then from 4:30 until 8 p.m., it's shut down. Okay, unless my kids are outside playing with friends and I'm not taking any time away from them or I'm not taking time away from my husband, that time is shut down for my family. And then from 8 to 8:30, I am wrapping up, tying up any loose ends. If I need to send out a share cart, I need to make my evening post, I need to tidy up my stories and make sure I didn't forget to post something on Facebook or whatever. It's just tying up those loose ends for the day. And then after that, it's done. I shut it down and I start again the next morning. But you have to schedule out your day so much more now than you do when you have to like go to work, because you have kind of a routine when you're going to work, right? But when you're home all day, you're like, oh, I'll get to it. Oh, I'll get to it. Oh, I'll get to it. And before you know it, the entire day is gone and you have maybe done the laundry and done things around the house, but you haven't sat down and been disciplined to work your business. So it's making sure that you're blocking out those times to work your business, get your personal things done as well, but also unplugging, okay? This is not Beachbody, and being a coach does not mean you have to be plugged in 24/7. It's learning to be disciplined and focused during the times of work, and then learning to also put it away. And that's something I have to focus on more at times. I'm really good sometimes, and then other times I get a little off course. But you have to put it away and unplug so you don't burn yourself out, and so you're present with your family too, okay? So having your list of to-dos, I actually went into blocks of time throughout your day was actually number three. So I kind of combined those two. So number two is making a list of your daily to-dos, personal as well as your success tracker, so that you're doing your business activities as well. And then number three was blocking out your schedule. So blocking out your times of day that you're going to work and when you're going to be unplugged, okay? Tip number four is visiting your personal and business goals every day, okay? Whether you're meditating over them or you're visualizing or you're writing them out through affirmations or all of them, we need to do that every single day. There is so much pulling us into negativity right now that we really have to keep our spirits high and to keep our vision alive, we have to revisit why we started this to begin with, right? What is our goal? What do we really want to achieve? And revisiting that every single day, not only for our personal goals, like what are your own personal health goals, but also what your business goals are, okay? So making sure you're writing that out every single day or visualizing, if you have it written down, like I have on my bookmark for my personal development book, I have several affirmations of my goals written out on a piece of paper. And then I can read through those as I do my as I get into my personal development book for the day, okay? So just a couple of things to help you focus on that as well. And then number five is focus on taking a step forward every single day. Starting out as a new coach, we get so excited and we want to jump both feet in and we're gung-ho. We're going to do this. And then we don't see much or maybe any progress or result from maybe the week or two that we've really been consistent, and we start to feel kind of defeated and we start to retreat and we start letting all those negative voices in our head say, I can't do that. I don't have the time. I'm not disciplined enough. I don't have enough friends. I'm not good on social media. I don't know how to invite. All of those things start flooding our mind, right? It's so easy to let that voice pipe up. This little book of mine, the chapter I was reading yesterday, it's called The Slight Edge by Jeff Olson. Super, super, super good book. I was reading it yesterday while my boys were playing, and PJ was kind of doing his own thing. I don't remember what he was doing, but anyway, he was doing his own thing. And I was reading it, and he talks about how when a baby is growing up and they see everybody walking around them all over the place, and they start to pull themselves up to start to walk. And they fall because they don't have the balance, they don't have the strength, and they don't know how to walk. But do they tell themselves, oh, you'll never walk. You suck. Just, you're going to crawl for the rest of your life. No, they get up and they do it again, and they might take a step and then they fall. And then they take another step and then they fall. And then they take two or three steps and then they fall again. But the fact is that they keep pushing forward because they know that they're going to master walking. They know that if they just keep doing it, that nothing in their brain has told them that they're going to fail. They don't look at falling down as failing. They just get up and try it again because they know, okay, I did one step, and they just keep taking one step forward every day. The baby steps count, you guys, and the baby steps are so much more important than taking giant leaps. This business does not grow in a giant leap. Just like your nutrition and fitness did not change with the flick of a switch. It took failing forward. It took messing up with food choices. It took not showing up for your workout a couple times and then feeling crummy about it. So then you showed up again. It's those little baby steps over time, the slight edge. It's those little steps compounded over time that are creating that lasting change. So I want to remind you to focus on those little steps. I have been doing those 15-minute power pockets every day this week. Every day. 15 minutes. Start where you are. If you only get that 15 minutes done, it was better than what you did the day before, right? Start where you are. Get into a habit and a routine of showing up for those 15 minutes and then do it. Say, okay, this week, I mastered doing those 15 minutes every single day with Corey for this entire week. Next week, I'm going to do 15 minutes twice a day, every single day. And build upon that, okay? Keep taking those steps forward and building on that previous step that you took. And I'm not saying it's always going to be steps forward. We all have setbacks. We all have challenges, but that's okay. We don't have to look at it as failure. We just have to look at it as an opportunity for growth. Okay. So just remember to focus on those small steps forward every single day. So I'm going to go back through the five tips. So the first one was to get yourself up, get started, don't sleep in and lay around all day. Get yourself up and moving and get your day like a normal routine would. Okay. So if you were waking up at 5:30, 6 o'clock in the morning, get in that routine to keep that going. Number two is to have your list of to-dos. What are the top three things that you need to accomplish in your business for the day? And what are the top three things that you need to accomplish in your personal life? What needs to be done around the house? And when those are done, walk away and be done for a little bit. Give yourself the opportunity to live and not just be living off of to-do lists all the time. You guys, I'm going to like go off tangent a little bit here for a minute, but I think that this is something that was done on purpose or whatever, but I truly believe that there is a message to take out of this, that we all wear this badge of busy, like it's an honor. And the busier you are, the better you are and the cooler you are. We all miss out on so much. And we literally went from the busiest season of our life. And I don't say that to be prideful. I say that because we as parents are making sacrifice for our kids to do something that they really, really loved. And that was, every second of that was amazing. And it was kind of a dagger in the heart when we couldn't go to that last tournament because we were looking forward to it just as much as the kids were. It's been an amazing season. But I also, now being home and not having to run to practice every single day of the week and be out of town every weekend, I see how much I was really missing time with my boys, how much I was missing making dinner every night and sitting at the dinner table as a family, how I was missing just listening to my kids read books sitting at the kitchen counter to each other and their laughs and their giggles and them playing in the playroom with their Legos and all the little things that we can never get back. I truly believe this is an opportunity for us to embrace slowing down and being more present in our lives. Okay. So yes, this is an opportunity to get a lot of things done, but it's also an opportunity, and I hope that you take it, to step away from the hamster wheel and embrace the life that you have right in front of you right now in the moment. Okay. So then tip number three is blocking out your day, blocking out those times. And if you have to do it on your Google Calendar, or you want to print a calendar off, or you have, Michelle, I just saw you have that Moira journal, which has the block, you can block out all of your times of the day through that. Block out your business hours, block out what personal time you need, like to get things done. If you're still working, then make sure you're blocking that work time out. Make sure you're blocking out whatever time you're going to need to cook dinner and to do laundry or whatever. But then also make sure you're taking time to totally unplug. And that means putting the phone up and putting it away and being present with your family, whether it's playing board games or having a family dinner or watching a movie, whatever that looks like for you guys. It's been a little bit of all of those for us lately, and it's been a lot of fun. So make sure that you're scheduling that time out for yourself as well. Number four is to visit your goals, personal and business, daily. So making a vision board, writing them out in a journal every day, visualizing them, like you can write them on a piece of paper and then visualize them every day, or meditating over them. But revisiting your goals every single day to empower why you're showing up for yourself. Okay. And then number five is just focus on and celebrate the steps forward every day. Like I said, if you're doing your workout, give yourself a pat on the back for that. If your nutrition was good, feel good about that. Don't ever feel ashamed of being prideful of the steps you're taking forward. The only one that is ever going to make you feel guilty for that are those who aren't willing to do it for themselves. So never feel ashamed of taking steps forward for yourself. And just focusing on the small steps compounding over time, and knowing that as long as you take a small step forward, like those 15-minute power pockets for your business, if you do that every single day for a month, imagine where you'll be. And it's 15 minutes. Like, we all have 15 minutes right now to show up for ourselves and for our business, okay? To show up for those goals that we set for ourselves. So be excited about taking those steps forward for yourself. It's going to make you show up and be excited for your goals, and then be excited to show up for your goals. Okay. That is all I have for tonight. Do you have any questions, my dear? No. All right. Well, I hope that that was helpful for you. If you're watching the playback and you have any questions, please just drop them in the comments below. I'm more than happy to answer. I will continue to do Monday through Saturday. I will do those 15-minute power pockets, but because Sundays are like really catch-up time for me, and I do a lot of like scheduling posts and things like that, and then we do our team call, I'm going to take Sundays off from doing the 15-minute power pockets. That doesn't mean that you have to take that day off, though. You can go back to the one on Saturday or Friday or whatever, or maybe you come up with your own routine that you're writing out. But Monday through Saturday, I will show up. It'll be different times of the day. It'll just be whenever it fits our schedule. Most of the time, it'll probably be around 3:15, 3:30. But I definitely encourage you girls to start jumping onto those. And just, even if you only do that 15 minutes for the day, you took a step forward, and I will be so, so proud of you for that. So I appreciate you jumping on. Like I said, if you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. And I hope you guys have an awesome week. I hope to see you tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. for our virtual gym. I will be on at 5. I've been getting on about 5:45, 5:50 because some of my workouts are 40 minutes long. So, all right. All right, girlfriend. I will talk to you later. Have a great week.